Hello and welcome to OptinMonster. We make it easy to create campaigns that turn your website traffic into leads and customers. In this video, I'll show you how to create your first OptinMonster campaign. But first, if you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more content like this. Now, let's get started. So here we are on the OptinMonster campaign dashboard. This is usually the first screen you'll see when you log into your OptinMonster account. From here, click the Create New Campaign button in the top right corner. Now, let's take a minute to go over the options you have here. First, let's take a look at playbooks. With playbooks, we've completely taken the guesswork out of campaign creation. We studied the conversion strategies of the most successful, inspiring brands in the world, then replicated those strategies for you in our well-designed, pre-configured campaigns. Each playbook showcases the original source of inspiration and the real-world, proven results our customers generated through its implementation. Based on the answers you provided during the onboarding survey, we'll present you with recommendations for your particular category and goal. However, you can also filter and search for specific playbooks too. Now, the great thing about playbooks is that they truly are plug and play. We've created the design, written the copy, and configured the display rules for you. All you have to do is select Use Playbook, check the campaign notes section to see what specific areas you need to personalize, such as updating the redirect URL of a button to point to your specific Facebook group, and you're ready to publish. The best part is, playbooks are available for all subscription plans. If your subscription doesn't include the powerful rules used in the suggested playbook, we'll automatically replace those rules with the best option available to you. Alright, let's take a step back and look at the other options. The only thing easier than using our playbooks to create your first campaign is letting someone else create it for you. And you can do just that. Just select Hire Our Specialist to customize any campaign. You can partner with the conversion experts at OptinMonster to grow your list, leads, and sales. Our team has decades of online marketing experience, and they've crafted thousands of OptinMonster campaigns. Our team will listen to your goals and challenges, then produce a custom, eye-catching OptinMonster campaign optimized to produce specific results, leaving you to do what's most important, tend to your business. Okay, let's do a 180 and consider the complete opposite end of the spectrum. If you prefer a blank slate where you can really let your creative juices flow, we've got you covered. Our Canvas option is perfect for you. With this option, you can create a completely customized campaign from scratch, tailoring the design and copy to your specific needs, and building your own customized set of display rules from the ground up. The only limit here is your imagination. All right, that just leaves the templates option. And just like its placement on the screen, it provides the perfect middle ground between our completely configured playbooks and our blank slate canvas. Choose from hundreds of designs that are proven to convert and simply edit the copy and configure the display rules to meet your specific needs. For our purposes today, I'll select this option. OptinMonster offers several campaign types to help you craft targeted offers. You can select from pop-up, floating bar, full screen, inline, slide-in, and if you have a growth subscription, gamified. Again, for our purposes today, I'll stick with pop-up. Next, browse the campaign templates to find the one you'd like to use. Use the filter to help narrow your options, and if you have a pro or higher subscription, you can select Mobile Optimize to create a mobile-only campaign. For this example, I'll select the basic template. You can click Preview to see an example, or click Use Template to select it. Next, give the campaign a descriptive title and assign it to a site or sites where you'd like it to appear. If you haven't added your site yet, click Add a New Website and enter the site name and domain. When you're finished, click Start Building. Next, you'll land on the Design tab where you can edit your campaign. From the footer menu, you can switch between editing the various views. The opt-in view collects your visitor's information, and the success view appears after your visitor completes the opt-in form. On Plus and higher plans, you'll also have the option to add a yes-no view, which allows you to create a two-step opt-in. Also from the footer menu, you can import the content from one view to another within this campaign, or import the content from any of the views of any of your other campaigns, switch to editing another campaign, and edit the campaign's details. When editing the content of a view, you can edit text in line and drag and drop other elements, such as images, buttons, and countdown timers, to name a few, onto your campaign. Simply point and click to edit any block, and the menu on the left will update so you can make your changes. For example, when you edit the Form Fields block, you can customize the form collecting your visitors' information to gather all the information you need from your leads. In a later step, you can map those fields directly to the appropriate fields in your email service provider or customer relationship management software. With a wide range of available blocks, Opt-in Monster makes it easy to design forms and pop-ups tailored to your website and audience. So when building your campaign, be sure to refer to our complete guide on choosing the right block for your campaign. When you're finished editing the content and design of your campaign, head over to Display Rules. Opt-in Monster's display rules truly are its secret sauce. You can create rule sets, a group of rules that defines the condition that allows or prevents your campaign from appearing, that are as simple or as complex as you need. And yes, a rule set can be as simple as a single rule, but you'll probably want to get a little more specific with your targeting than that. And you can do that by combining rules in a group using all or any one operators. If you use the any one operator, the group of rules will be true if any single one of the conditions in the group is true. However, if you use the all operator, the group of rules will only be true if all of the conditions in the group are true at the same time. For example, the default rule set is a simple group of rules using the all operator to show the opt-in view when the visitor has been on any page for at least 5 seconds. Taking this one step further, you can create multiple groups of rules within each rule set. Groups of rules are linked by AND, meaning that for the rule set to be true, all groups of rules must be true at the same time. So for example, let's add a group of rules to the default group. I'll add an exit intent condition as well as a scroll distance condition. I'll set this group to use the any one operator. Now I've just created a rule set that will show the opt-in view of the campaign when the user has been on any page for at least 5 seconds, and the user is either attempting to leave or has scrolled at least 15% of the page. So with just a few clicks, I've created a pretty specific scenario, and this just barely scratches the surface of what Opt-in Monster's display rules can do. We've got rules for just about every scenario you can dream up. We've grouped our most popular rules for quick access, but you also have rules specifically for who, when, and where, as well as rules for on-site retargeting based on user behavior on your site, and we even have rules specifically for e-commerce. If you ever need a little more information about what each rule is or does, we've provided a link to our documentation, as well as a quick explainer video for each rule. When working with a rule in a group, you can quickly duplicate it or hide it. When you hide a rule in a group, it removes it as a qualifying condition without deleting it. Additionally, you can drag and drop rules to reorder them or move them to other groups. To add yet another layer of customization, you can even create multiple rule sets with completely different rules for each campaign. Now, only one single rule set needs to have all of its rules passed for the campaign to display, meaning that rule sets are connected with the any one operator in a technical sense. So, as you can see, there are countless display rule configurations, allowing you to create simple or complex rule sets based on your specific needs. And once you've created your rule set, you can even save it and import it to your other campaigns. This can be especially useful if you have different campaigns for various seasons, sales, or holidays, but use the same or similar rule sets. Instead of recreating the rule sets each time, you can simply save and import. Now let's move on to actions. Here, you can choose how often the campaign appears to visitors by configuring the campaign cookies. For example, if someone has closed and not converted the campaign, you can determine if or when the visitor sees the campaign again, and likewise for someone who has converted the campaign. And if your site uses subdomains, you can apply these rules there as well. And if you have a plus or higher subscription, you can add monster effects, animation, and sound to your pop-up campaigns to catch your visitors' attention and increase conversions. Finally, let's move on to the summary. Here, you can review all the display rule settings you've configured for this campaign. If everything looks good, you can move on to integrations, where you'll connect Opt-in Monster to your email service provider. If you've already set up a default integration in your account settings, you'll see it here. Otherwise, you can search for your provider and connect to it now. We've provided a link to our documentation for the instructions on connecting to your specific integration. If you don't have an email marketing service set up, you can connect to MonsterLeads, our in-house lead storage system, which allows you to get started gathering leads. In fact, even if you have an email marketing service, we recommend connecting MonsterLeads as a backup to your email service provider. After you've connected your integration, you'll need to map any fields you added to your opt-in form beyond the default name, email, and phone fields, which are mapped to the default fields in your email service provider automatically. Now, each provider handles this a bit differently, but again, we've documented all those details and conveniently linked to the article specific to your provider here. After you've set up your email service provider, head over to Analytics. This is where you connect your campaigns to Google Analytics for more advanced analytics data. Optin Monster Analytics will automatically track basic analytics data, such as impressions, conversions, and highest converting pages. If you want to connect to your Google Analytics account, be sure to follow our guide. I've left a link in the description. And finally, head over to Publish. This is where you'll do a final review of all the details of your campaign and publish it to your site. Check the right columns checklist for any gray circles next to items, letting you know that something is missing or may need to be fixed before publishing. If everything looks good, click Publish to make your campaign live, and then click Save. If you've not yet added the Optin Monster embed code to your site or activated our WordPress plugin, then you have one more important step to take. The platform section of the page contains all the code or instructions you will need to connect Optin Monster to your website. Check out our documentation for complete details. I've left a link in the description. And that's it. We've successfully created and launched our first Optin Monster campaign. If you have any questions, browse through our helpful documentation, or for further assistance, you can submit a support ticket and we'd be happy to help.